Texas is recognized.
Mr. President, I want to talk today about Russia. I want to talk about Vladimir Putin. I want to describe to this chamber a bipartisan victory that together we won. And then I want to describe tragically how President Joe Biden is giving that victory away to Putin and Russia. To understand this issue, we need to go back to the summer of 2019. In the summer of 2019, Russia was in the process of constructing a pipeline called the Nord Stream 2 pipeline. Behind me is a map demonstrating where the Nord Stream 2 pipeline runs. It is a pipeline that was to run from Russia to Germany, going underneath the Baltic Sea. In the summer of 2019, the pipeline was nearly complete. At various periods in time, it was 70% complete, 80% complete. There was widespread consensus that if this pipeline were completed, it would have devastating consequences. In a few minutes, I will discuss those consequences in greater detail. But in an effort to stop the devastating consequences, I worked on bipartisan legislation, along with Senator Jeanne Shaheen, Democrat from New Hampshire, and we introduced bipartisan sanctions legislation designed to stop the Nord Stream 2 pipeline. That legislation, when we introduced it, was almost immediately subject to a Russian disinformation campaign. In Europe, the Russians were saying to anyone who would listen that the Cruz-Shaheen sanction legislation could never pass, that there was no way Congress would come together in a bipartisan manner to stop the Nord Stream 2, that it was hopeless, that no one needed to be concerned that this legislation could pass. They also made the argument as part of their disinformation campaign that the pipeline was nearly complete, so that U.S. sanctions could not stop it. There was nothing that could be done to stop it. Well, Mr. President, to the surprise of nobody who follows these issues, that Russian disinformation was precisely that. It was disinformation. It was lies. The Senate Foreign Relations Committee, Senator Shaheen and I worked with our colleagues. And our legislation was initially voted out of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee by an overwhelming bipartisan vote of 20-2. Overwhelming bipartisan support. At that point, Senator Shaheen and I began working to get it passed on the floor of the Senate. While we were doing so, the Russian disinformation continued. This cannot pass. We endeavored to have our sanctions legislation attached to the National Defense Authorization Act, which was moving in the fall and winter of 2019. To do so, Mr. President, was not easy. To do so, we needed to get the explicit sign-off of the chairman and the ranking member of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee. We needed the explicit sign-off of the chairman and the ranking member of the Senate Armed Services Committee. We needed the explicit sign-off of the chairman and ranking member of the Senate Banking Committee. And then we needed the explicit sign-off of Senator McConnell and Senator Schumer, the Republican and Democratic leader, respectively. All eight of those individuals, all eight of those senators needed to agree with our legislation for this to proceed on the NDAA. And then, Mr. President, we had to do the exact same thing in the House of Representatives and get the chairman and ranking member on foreign relations, on armed services, on banking, and we had to get the sign-off of Nancy Pelosi and Kevin McCarthy. To get the explicit support of all 16 of those congressional leaders, 8 Republicans and 8 Democrats, in any world is not easy. And I will say, on my part and Senator Shaheen's part, we invested dozens, if not hundreds of hours in terms of talking to our colleagues to build that bipartisan consensus. And we ended up getting that overwhelming support. In many ways, that support was miraculous. Why is that? Well, one of the reasons why Nord Stream 2 is particularly problematic is that Russia is building Nord Stream 2 in order to cut off Ukraine. There is currently a pipeline running through Ukraine, and through Nord Stream 2, Russia has the power to starve Ukraine. Why is it miraculous in December of 2019 that we're able to pass this legislation? Well, if you recall what was happening in the House of Representatives in December of 2019, the House of Representatives was in the middle of impeaching President Donald Trump for alleged high crimes and misdemeanors concerning Ukraine. If you recall, Mr. President, from the trial we held on this Senate floor, central to the allegations that were raised by Democrats against President Trump was conduct concerning Ukraine. It remains astonishing that right in the middle of a partisan gladiatorial battle concerning Ukraine, simultaneously we were able to get Republicans and Democrats to work hand in hand to agree with complete consensus that we were going to come together and stop the Nord Stream 2 pipeline. We were going to stop what Vladimir Putin was doing. In December of 2019, our legislation passed. The Cruz-Shaheen sanctions legislation passed. Now, Mr. President, I will remind you of what the Russian disinformation had been when we first introduced it. They said it'll never pass. And they said even if it does pass, it's too late for it to have any effect. Well, if my memory serves me correctly, President Trump signed the Cruz-Shaheen sanctions legislation at 7 p.m. on a Thursday. At 6:45 p.m. on a Thursday, 15 minutes before our sanctions legislation was signed into law, the company that was laying the pipeline in the Baltic Sea announced it had immediately halted laying the pipeline, and it was lifting anchor and sailing away. It was an incredible bipartisan victory. The pipeline was stopped in its tracks. What happened next was absolutely nothing. For a year, the pipeline lay dormant. The talking point from Vladimir Putin, and now sadly adopted by Joe Biden and his administration, is the pipeline is 90% complete, or the pipeline is 95% complete. But, Mr. President, it is not rocket science that a 90% complete pipeline is 0% complete. Until you complete both ends of the pipeline, it ain't nothing but a hunk of metal at the bottom of the ocean. Nothing is traveling through it until the pipeline is complete and online. For a year, the pipeline lay dormant. Then in the year 2020, Senator Shaheen and I joined together again in a second round of bipartisan legislation. A second round of sanctions. We had stopped the Nord Stream 2 pipeline in its tracks. For a year, Putin was stopped altogether, and we came together for a second piece of legislation, the second version of Cruz-Shaheen, and just like the first sanctions, we passed it through both houses of Congress, and it was signed into law. With overwhelming bipartisan support, nearly unanimous support of all 535 members of Congress. So we now had two major pieces of sanctions legislation on the books, and those sanctions had been working. For a year, the pipeline was stopped. Then in November of 2020 was the presidential election. And in the wake of the presidential election, Joe Biden and his transition team almost immediately began telegraphing weakness to Russia. Members of Joe Biden's foreign policy advisory team in the German newspapers expressed openness to Nord Stream 2 being built, expressed a willingness to try to circumvent the sanctions that had been working and had worked for over a year. Within days of Joe Biden and his team expressing weakness to Putin, Russia and Putin heard, and they began the process of getting ready to return to building the pipeline. Russia did return to building the pipeline. Do you know what day, Madam President? January 24th, 2021. 4 days after Joe Biden was sworn into office, Putin said, "We're safe, we're free, our man Joe is in the White House." And we know that the administration is not going to follow U.S. law anymore. And so on January 24th, the Russians returned to building the pipeline. Now, for 2 years, this body had been united, Republicans and Democrats, that we were going to stop this pipeline. But Joe Biden and his administration decided instead to waive the sanctions, decided instead to give Vladimir Putin what amounts to a multi-billion dollar gift. And not just a gift one time. If this pipeline is allowed to go online, it will put billions of dollars in Putin's pockets every year, year after year after year. What are the consequences of Nord Stream 2? Number one, Russia gets richer, Russia gets stronger, Russia gets billions of dollars that it can use to build its military, to threaten its neighbors, to threaten our allies, to endanger the lives of Americans and our friends. Number two, Europe is hurt. Our friends and allies in Europe are made even more dependent on Russian energy. Madam President, our former colleague in this body, Senator John McCain, may he rest in peace. He had a phrase for Russia that was memorable, that I've used many times. He referred to Russia as a gas station with a country attached. That is Putin's plan. It is very simple. Putin is a petro-tyrant. He's a tyrant. He's a bully. He's a KGB thug, and all of his aggression is funded by selling oil and gas. Together, Republicans and Democrats in Congress had taken billions out of Putin's pockets. And sadly, Joe Biden and Kamala Harris decided the world would be a better place if instead Putin had billions more, not just this year or next year, but for decades to come. When Putin is dead and buried and the next dictator is ruling over Russia, that next dictator will be reaping the benefits of this pipeline. Indeed, as a result of Joe Biden's decision, many are referring to this pipeline as the Biden-Putin pipeline. For a very simple reason, it is Putin that is building it, it is Putin that is profiting by it, and the only reason Putin is allowed to do so is because President Joe Biden has given him a multi-billion dollar gift that strengthens Russia and it weakens Europe. It makes Europe subject to energy blackmail. Putin has demonstrated a willingness and indeed a history of using energy blackmail, of using those who are dependent on natural gas to coerce them to do what he wants. In the dead of winter, when people are at risk of freezing to death, Putin has threatened to and has in fact cut off gas to endanger the lives of innocent civilians in order to coerce governments to bending to his will. As a result of Joe Biden's surrender to Vladimir Putin, Putin will have the continued ability to exercise economic blackmail against Europe. But not only that, Europe has energy needs. Those energy needs could be readily satisfied by American energy. Europe has expressed a willingness and, in some instances, an eagerness to import American energy. But Joe Biden has decided that American jobs are unimportant. His first day in office, Biden shut down the Keystone Pipeline, killing 11,000 jobs in the United States, including 8,000 union jobs, 8,000 high-paying union jobs that, with a stroke of a pen, Joe Biden eliminated. And at the exact same time that Biden is shutting down jobs at a pipeline in America, he is greenlighting and giving a gift to Vladimir Putin of a pipeline between Russia and Germany, producing jobs in Russia, producing billions of dollars in Russia, and taking away jobs in America. This pipeline is a disaster. As the afternoon goes on, I will elaborate on different aspects in which it is harmful and on the steps we can and should be taking to stop it. But at this point, Senator Barrasso is here and has some thoughts he wishes to express, and so I will yield the floor to Senator Barrasso for his remarks.
All right, folks, thank you so much for joining us here at Golden State Times. If you're new to the channel, we encourage you to subscribe by clicking that middle button. Also, check out our previous video by clicking the video on the right, or a video you might enjoy by clicking the video on the left. Also, don't forget to click the thumbs up button and share this video on social media. Peace.